Anthony Albanese has been forced to defend the landmark AUKUS submarines deal and his cabinet ministers following a blistering attack from a former prime minister. Paul Keating's comments today labelled out of touch amid China's strategic ambitions in the region.
This is the USS Asheville, a Los Angeles-class nuclear-powered submarine making a Perth port call, the first of many to chart a new course down under.
Starting immediately, we will see an increased tempo of American and British submarines visiting Western Australia.
The Deputy Prime Minister today spruiking the AUKUS defence deal, the Foreign Minister too at the SA shipyard, while Anthony Albanese came out to defend them after Paul Keating fired a shot, calling the Cabinet Ministers seriously unwise.
He's entitled to put his opinion. I think on those issues he's wrong. He has my respect. And I have no intention of engaging in a public argument with Paul Keating.
A debate about the entire AUKUS subs deal.
It must be the worst deal in all history.
The former PM insists China's not a threat despite its rapid military build-up in the region.
Keating has his views, but in substance and in tone, they belong to another time.
The circumstances in our region have changed dramatically. I think every Australian except Paul Keating gets that.
A former Liberal PM's critical too, Malcolm Turnbull says compared to the subs deal he struck with France.
This will take a lot more time, cost a great deal more money, have a lot more risk.
Now that Anthony Albanese's back in the country, it's not former prime ministers he has to convince this is a good deal, but the Australian public.
My responsibility in 2023 is to give Australia the leadership that they need now, not what they might have needed in the 1990s.
Let's go to Chloe Bourras now at Parliament House in Canberra. Chloe, the government is claiming another win this week with today's jobs figures showing an improvement in the unemployment rate. What does it actually mean?
Well, to put this in context, 64,000 people found work last month, and that takes the unemployment rate back to where it was before the summer break, which is a time when a lot of people change jobs, so the numbers do fluctuate. The question now is, what does this mean for interest rates? Because the Reserve Bank looks very closely at the unemployment data. Now, some economists believe that because the number is still very low, the RBA will be incentivized to go even harder. But the financial markets are predicting that it will actually hold off because of the unfolding situation in the global bank system. And if the US central bank doesn't lift interest rates, then there's less pressure on Australia to do so. But that's still a few weeks away. So for today, the government is claiming a win.
We see the strength of the Australian economy, the strength of Australians going in and getting jobs, compared to the hysteria of an opposition that basically finds ways to say no.
But Australians will be working longer for less money unless the country lifts its productivity performance, and that will be detailed in a 5-year report to be released tomorrow.